This is the 27th video in our series, looking at how to complete a basic setup and configuration of a Synology Network Attached Storage Device, or as they're more commonly referred to, a NAS. Having now installed and configured audio, video, and photo station, we are in a position where we can install and configure an application onto our NAS called Media Server. Media Server is an application that allows us to stream the multimedia content stored on our NAS to a digital media adapter. A DMA is a device that is compatible with a standard created by the Digital Living Network Alliance and includes devices such as the Sony PlayStation, Microsoft Xbox, Roku, and most smart TVs. For devices such as the Apple TV and the Amazon Fire TV, we can install the Synology Photo Station, Music Station, or Video Station apps. So in this video, we're going to take a look at the process for installing Media Server onto our NAS. Then with Media Server installed, we will review the configuration options that are available for us to use. Finally, we will demonstrate how we can stream the multimedia content stored on our NAS to a Sony PlayStation 4. In order to install and configure Media Server, we first need to log into the Disk Station Manager using our administrator's credentials. From the DSM's desktop, we now need to select Package Center. When Package Center opens, we are shown a screen that displays all of the packages that can be installed on this model of Synology NAS. In order to find the Media Server package, we can use the provided filters. If we change the category filter from All Packages to Multimedia, Media Server will be listed as one of the multimedia packages that we can install. An alternative method for finding packages within Package Center is via the search bar. If we type Media Server, then press Enter on the keyboard, the Media Server package will once again be listed. Let's select Install and take a look at the process for installing this package onto our NAS. After the Media Server package has been downloaded to our NAS, we are presented with an install wizard. As the NAS that we are working from has been configured with multiple volumes, we need to choose which volume we will be installing the Media Server package onto. As Media Server will simply stream the contents from existing network shares on our NAS, unlike Music, Photo, and Video Station, we can install the Media Server package onto Volume 1, which is also where we have the operating system of our NAS installed. We will leave Always Install New Packages on this volume in the future unticked, as this will offer us greater flexibility in the future as to where we install packages. When we select Next, we're asked to confirm our settings. You can see that the Media Server application will automatically start running after it's been installed. Let's select Apply. The Media Server package is now downloaded and installed onto our NAS. With Media Server now installed and running, let's close Package Center and take a look at the settings that we can change within Media Server. From the DSM desktop, if we select Main Menu, you can see that a Media Server icon has been added to our main menu. When we select Media Server, we are taken to the General Settings pane for Media Server. On the left side of the Media Server panel, we have three options: General Settings, Browsing Settings, and Dma Compatibility. Let's start with General Settings. First, we are informed that Media Server will look to the photo, music, and video network shared on our NAS for content it can stream to any digital media adapter connected to our home network. We're also told that we can add or edit which folders the NAS uses to stream multimedia content with by using the settings in Media Indexing. DMA Language allows us to set the language used within the menu system of our digital media adapter. It's best practice to set this option to the same language as used by our DMA. DMA Menu Style allows us to choose how multimedia files will be organized within the menu of our digital media adapter. While SSDP, or Simple Service Discovery Protocol, is a method that Media Server uses to advertise itself to any digital media adapter connected to our home network. As the SSDP advertisement interval will allow us to control how often Media Server advertises itself to our home network, we can use this setting to troubleshoot network and connection issues between the media server and our DMA. However, for now, we will leave this setting on its default of 920. Let's select Browsing Settings from the sidebar. As you can see, within Browsing Settings, we are presented with a number of options that allow us to adjust how video, music, and photographs will be displayed when viewed from our digital media adapter. The drop-down menu next to Music Display Format will offer five different ways that the music stored on our NAS can be listed. However, for this example, we will leave this option set to its default of Title Only. The drop-down menus for Sort Photo By will allow our photographs to be displayed on our digital media adapter either by file name or by the date that the photograph was taken. We can also choose to see these photographs listed in either ascending or descending order. If your photographs were taken in a high-quality file format, more than likely they will be of a large file size. While large file sizes should not present too much of a problem when browsing images from our DMA, for this example, we will enable Transmit Low-Resolution Images instead of the original images to help ensure that when we view photographs from our DMA, we can quickly browse through our photo library. The option Display Cover Image for Audio and Video Files we will leave disabled, as enabling this function would require a lot of additional work on our part to restructure the contents of the video and music files in our network shares. Show Video Title using embedded information, if we were to enable it, would use the title of the movie as defined in its metadata rather than use the title taken from its file name. The option Enable Internet Radio is fairly self-explanatory, but for this example, we will leave this setting disabled. Integrate Video Station Database into Media Server, if enabled, we'll try and use the data stored by Video Station to add a number of categories that will help us sort our movie library. You will see the categories when we test Media Server with our digital media adapter. Let's select Apply and take a look at the options in Dma Compatibility. The first option in Dma Compatibility offers us the opportunity to enable audio transcoding. Transcoding is where a digital file is converted from one file format to another by our NAS. For less well-known audio files, transcoding will increase the chance that that audio track can be played back on our digital media adapter. However, as all of the audio tracks on our NAS are using a file format that is fully compatible with our digital media adapter, we will leave this option disabled. Enable Customized MIME Types is an option that we can use to help us stream media files with file extensions that our digital media adapter does not recognize. For example, a movie can be encoded in a specific video format like H.264. However, that file format can use a number of different file extensions, for example, .mov, .mp4, and .mpv. So if the file extension of our movie file is not recognized by our digital media adapter, rather than re-encode the movie, we could try and customize the MIME type to help our DMA recognize the file format of our video. However, from personal experience, rather than trying to understand MIME types and file formats, I have found it far easier to pick a file format that I know is compatible with all of my media devices, and then make sure that all of my movie content has been encoded to that file format before it's uploaded to my NAS. The final option in DMA compatibility is change the settings of UPnP Dlna devices within LAN. This option will allow us to determine which devices can or cannot access Media Server. As we have not yet tested, that Media Server will allow us to stream media content to a digital media adapter, we will not enable this function. Let's select Apply to make sure that any changes that we have made are saved before we close the Media Server panel. Now from the DSM desktop, let's log out of DStation Manager and test that we can connect a digital media adapter to Media Server. For this example, we will use a Sony PlayStation 4 as our digital media adapter. This is because not only is the PS4 a games console with Dlna compatibility, it should also make a good general purpose entertainment device for our living room. From the crossbar of the PlayStation 4's main menu, we need to locate and select Media Player. If you find that Media Player is not listed on the crossbar of your PS4, you need to download it from the PS Store. As you can see, we have not used Media Player for a while, so we will first need to update it. We are now informed that we can connect either USB storage or a media server to our console. Let's select Enter. We should find that our NAS is listed underneath Recently Played and Favorites. Let's select our NAS. We can now see the network folders of our music, photo, and video shares. We also have a folder called Video Station, which in this example will be a duplicate of the contents of our video folder. If we select the music folder, we can browse the contents of the music share on our NAS using a number of different categories. Let's select All Music. Within All Music, you can see the music track that we added to our NAS in a previous video. Let's select Back and take a look at the Photo folder. Within the Photo folder, we have our Countryside album and the two photographs that we added to our NAS when we took a look at installing Photo Station. When we select Countryside, we can see our slideshow. Let's return to the main menu and then select Video. Under Video, you can see that we are presented with a list of all the movies stored on our NAS. Unfortunately, it does not appear that the PlayStation 4 is able to display the poster art for the movies that we have listed. Let's select Syntool by pressing Enter on the controller. Let's return to the Media Player's main menu and take a look at the folder called Video Station. The Video Station folder will only show content that is available via Video Station. However, because it refers to the Video Station database, it will offer a number of categories that we can use to help find the movie that we want to watch. By selecting Movie, we can see the different categories that we can browse by. For now, let's simply select All, to once again list all of the films that are available in Video Station. So to recap, in this video we installed Media Server onto our NAS. We then took a look at the configuration options Media Server makes available for us to use. Finally, we tested that we could connect a digital media adapter to Media Server. In the next video in this series, we're going to take a look at configuring an Apple-style time capsule onto our Synology NAS. This will allow us to use some of the storage space on our NAS to act as a location where Windows 10 and Apple Macintosh computers can automatically back up to.